Hi everyone, this is Ash and welcome to my latest video. Tonight I thought I'd do something a bit different, as I did mention in a couple of past mini reviews that I've recently uploaded that I was going to cover this subject in more depth, and this first tutorial, although it's fairly straightforward, but this is more aimed at newcomers to the hobby. And the topic I'm talking about is adding a driver or a crew, depending on the sort of train you wish to add realism to. Depends on the type of unit. As normally, on something like the Class 153, they usually have a driver and a guard. And in the background, which is the two packs of Kato railway staff figures, you get three drivers and three guards. This pack of knock figures is marketed for road vehicles, and I will cover more on this in another video, but I just thought I'd show them in the first video just to give you an idea of what can be achieved in the world of modelling. However, depending on the type of locomotive or unit you will be modifying for this realism, I'd recommend you'll need some of this, which is the cyano acrylic adhesive, in other words, super glue. This will firmly fix your driver and guard in place without the worry of them coming apart inside the cab due to knocks and bumps, which is often the case with weaker glues. Also, you will need a crafts knife. This is to cut the glue bond in order to remove the cab interior on some locomotives or diesel multipole units. But like I said, every locomotive is different. And in some cases, a screwdriver. So what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to move these two packs of figurines out of the way. I'll just prop them against the Class 60 just to give you a guide of what is available. Just for the record of this tutorial, the reference number of these packs of figures is 6-529, and it is part of the Kato HO range. I am fully aware that these are Japanese drivers and conductors, so they may not be truly realistic, but it bridges the gap of having a crew on your train and not at all. But just for the record, other companies such as Knock and Prizer also make train crews as well. So it may pay to have a browse on Google to see their ranges available, but unfortunately I couldn't obtain any for this tutorial. So I will be back in a moment once I've unpacked the crews, and also I will have the interior out of the Class 60 shown in the shot there, as I will be fitting a driver to this particular locomotive. So, I'll be back in a moment, stay tuned. Just a brief view of the cab interior, and this is the model of my fictional DB Schenker locomotive that you may have noticed on my introductions to my 2014 range of videos. I have stripped out the cab interior of the end that I wish to add the driver to, and if I just zoom in with the camera, I have dug out my tripod just to give me a bit more room on the operational desk, but as you can see, the Class 60 interior is quite well detailed. And depending on if your model is brand new, these cab units are often glued into position, so you will need a sharp crafts knife in order to cut the bond. So what I'm going to do with this one, I'm going to stop the video and fit the driver into position, and then I will use the same techniques with another locomotive, and I will work from behind the camera to do this. So I'll be back in a moment. And with a little bit of patience and also with some careful handling, you only need a little smidge of glue on the base of the seat, and with the finished result you should end up with your driver fixed firmly into position like this. However, just allow a moment or two for the glue to set and dry, and then once the glue is completely dried, we can then put the cab partition back into the locomotive body shell and therefore reassemble the locomotive. You could, if you wished, fit a second man into the other seat, although I'm not going to do this right now, but I will do this with some other trains, like on the HST. But this is the end result, and also, in my opinion, this looks a lot better than having no driver at all. Right, I shall be back in a moment, and I will repeat the process with a different locomotive. So, stay tuned. And here is your final result after putting the locomotive back together. This is what we're actually greeted with. You may notice that the driver appears to be waving, or probably about to do a two-tone horn, but nonetheless, I'm sure you will agree that it does look a lot better now, doesn't it? Well, that's the little preview over. I'm going to put this locomotive to one side. Although the glue has set, I am going to allow it 24 hours to completely dry and set so that it's firm before I move the locomotive about too much, as the last thing I want to do is dislodge the driver from her seat. And as you may have noticed, this driver is actually female, as you do get four males, which two are guards, two are drivers, and you get one female guard and one female driver. So you do get a nice variety in these packs of Kato figures. But anyways, like I promised, I'm going to prepare another locomotive and I'm going to show you how to do it. So, back in a moment. Right, as you can see here, the locomotive that I've chosen is my 59206, which I reviewed back in 2013. So if you want to go and check the review of that locomotive, you will find it in my library. Although it's not yet an archive video, but I'm going to discuss some of the changes to my channel in another video later on. But meanwhile, sticking on topic, which is this tutorial, you may have to make some adjustments to your figures, as unfortunately the footwell between the console desk and the driver's seat, which is moulded onto this ex-Lima Class 59, the legroom is a little bit tight. So what I've done, I've just done some modifications by stripping a little bit of plastic off the feet. And just like I promised, now that I've removed the figure, I shall add a tiny drop of this super glue into the seating area. You don't need much because this is quite strong stuff. Just a tiny smidge will be enough to fix him in place. And this literally sets in about a couple of minutes. So just before that, just want to make sure that I'm happy with his final position. Which I am now. And there you go. There's your driver. Just need to push him firmly down into the seating well. So please excuse the fingers. I'm doing this to make sure the glue has enough contact between the figure and the cab seat, and also just to make sure he's sitting correctly. Right, I'm just going to make some adjustments. I'll be back in a moment. Now, what I've actually done in order to get the driver to fit, because he is slightly too tall to fit snugly into the cab footwell, as the seat is a little bit too low, I have attached the driver to the cab unit via the seat backrest. So if you're having problems fitting the driver flush into the driver's seat, which is a problem on these older models, as this is an ex-Lima Class 59, you may need to do some alternative measures to fit the driver into position. Now, if I just, as you can see, the glue is starting to dry already. This is quite fast drying super glue, so just like I mentioned with the Loctite, please take care when handling super glues, as it's very easy to bond your fingers together. I really should have said this at the start of the tutorial, so apologies for that, but likewise, it's always best to be safe than sorry. But I do hope that this video will be useful to those that are thinking of doing this with their model trains. And I shall be back once I've fitted a driver into another locomotive, just to show what the improvements are when a modeler decides to upgrade their model. So, I shall finish this video with three locomotives with drivers fitted. I will do another footage when it comes to fitting passengers into carriages and also diesel multiple units. So there will be an extra video to come after this in a separate upload. So if you're willing to want to know how to fit passengers into your carriages and stuff, it's quite simply the same principle as with the drivers. And as you can probably guess, this is my first tutorial, but I've now upgraded two of my locomotives with a driver. And just like I've previously said, I hope this will prove useful to those that are new to model railways, or for some ideas. So, I shall bring this video to a close with a lineup of three locomotives. And here is the three locomotives that I have fitted the three drivers from the first pack of Kato train crew. As you can see, it definitely makes a big improvement. And also, I have added the third driver to my Class 67, which is the new style Hornby one. However, I did find that when taking the cab unit out of the leading cab, which is this one on the right, and I shall just zoom in to give you a view of that. Apologies for the loss of focus there. You can just see the driver kind of giving a little wave at the desk of 67018. Here is another driver giving a wave on my Beast 6008, albeit this is a fictional locomotive. And finally, 59206 is where the second driver that I showed you in this mini tutorial is sitting in cab number one. Right, that concludes my tutorial of this rather interesting video. I do hope it's helpful to some of you out there. Thank you for watching. Please feel free to rate, comment and subscribe, and if you have any questions about this tutorial, please do not hesitate to post any questions in the comment section below. But in the meantime, have a great week everyone, and stay tuned for another video coming soon. Take care.